But I mean, you walk around it a little bit.
That's all four. And there's Gandalf is over there with his dog.
You like this one?
Yes.
Yeah. You seen the climbers as well?
Yeah. I see one of them.
Yeah.
Is it purely a fictitious layout?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It's a bit of fun. It's for fun for the kids. Also for me, and it's loosely based in Austria, Switzerland, Germany, because that's where I used to live.
Yeah.
So I just like making it up. And it's called Kaninchenbau.
So it's N-gauge track, but then sort of, yeah.
It's N-gauge, 9mm track,
yeah.
But it's built 3.5mm scale, so right. It's HOE.
Yeah.
And all the stock is commercial. You can buy all this. Yeah, just over 2.7. Just over 30 inches. Which is a UK equivalent. What you're trying to do is you're trying to get it to stop accurately at a particular point. You're putting it, when you...
Do you have to use any dead tracks to do that? Or
no, no. What you'll see is, if you look at that one there, that has just entered a lot, and you see it's counting where its position is at the moment.
Okay.
You can just see it there. Before the end of what? It will forward calculate, say, so, okay, I need to start breaking down. To get it to stop on that point. And that's what you see here. And it's not, people think it's very expensive and important, and it's not actually that expensive. If you've got a DCC layer already, which you control using something like that, the additional cost to automate this layer, £250 in the program, about that, in euros. And
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. something.
Is it?
It just lists, you know, you go to exhibition and they're all listed.
I'll look that up then.
There's 200 and something.
Okay.
Thank you. good. So I always like big boys to let them know that. So I'm sorry, we're going to see that.